Welcome back. So in the previous videos we have been discussed about the introduction and different types of definitions we have been discussed in this. So in this video we are going to see about the what I mean by pairing elements, degrees of freedom, machine mechanism and structure, and difference between the machine mechanism and a structure. So these are the topics that we are going to be see that we will see in this video. Yes, pairing elements is nothing but an pairing means, as you know, that elements is nothing but types of links or bodies which is to transmit the motion from one form to the other, from one link to the other, in order to transmit the motion. Now, what we mean by pairing elements? The pairing elements is nothing but the geometrical forms of which the two members of mechanisms, geometrical form of which two members of a mechanism are joined together so that there will be a relative motion between these two will be consistent. This is known as a pairing elements. Means the geometrical forms of two members of mechanisms are joined together with a relative motion between these two members will be consistent. So that is what we known as a pairing elements. And the pairs are also called as called kinematic pairs. So each individual link of a mechanism forms a pairing element. Means each individual link of mechanisms, as we have been discussed in the earlier topics. So different motions will form a mechanism, and the different mechanisms will form a complete machine. So the pairing elements is nothing but a joining of two members or mechanisms are joined together with a relative motion which will be having a consistent. That is what we known as a pairing element. You can able to see it in the figure here, that is having a relative motion with the two members in order to form the one mechanism. That is what we call it as a kinematic pair, or even we call it as a pairing element. So in this figure, one more figure you can able to see, this is with having a degrees of freedom. This figure is with respect to the degrees of freedom, where you can able to see three axes, that is x, y and z, and which will another in the body you can able to see in this body one, either it can able to move in the translation or rotation, and either the combination of both the translation or rotation. You can see that arrow mark, indicated arrow mark, where it can able to see that. You can able to see this, either it can able to move in the y direction, it can able to move in the z direction, and even it can able to move in the x direction. Yes, we have seen the pairing elements. Now we see what do you mean by a degree of freedom. So it is the number of independent coordinates required to describe the position of the body in a space. As we know that generally a normal body in a space will be having 6 degrees of freedom. So each degree will be having, each provides in a one motion along with that. So it can able to move in that particular direction, one motion along with that particular direction. So normally six degrees means it must provide in a 6 degrees. But how it can able to consider that 6 degrees is nothing but where either it can able to move x, y, z, that is a three direction, or what we call it as a translation, rotation, and a combination of both the translation and rotation. See, at a time it cannot able to move all the 6 degrees, so it can able to move in the 2 degrees, with 1 degree will be, or one constraint will be fixed, or one constraint will be fixed, another 2 axes it can able to move. So that is what we call it as a degrees of freedom. Means independent coordinates required to describe the position of a body in the space. So each part of a machine which moves relative to the some other part, that is what we known as a kinematic link. And a link may consist of several parts which is rigidly fastened together, so that that can able to provide the relative motion to the other inside the machines. See, the each parts of the machines will be interlinked or interconnected in order to provide the relative motion. That is what we called as an element, or what we call this as a kinematic link. So the degrees of freedom is nothing but independent coordinates which is required to describe the position, means in which direction or which position it has been moving, or which it is, which position or which moment it has been constrained, right? So this is about a degree of freedom. So next we're going to discuss about the machine mechanism and a structure. So mechanism, generally what is mean by a mechanism? So mechanism is a combination of both the rigid bodies or a resisting bodies, so formed and connected that they move upon each other within a definite definite relative motion. That is what we call it as a mechanism. For example, if we take some mechanism, crank and connecting rod, even in the IC engines, steering mechanisms of automobiles. So like this we have in a different examples, or so many examples are there in the mechanisms with respect to the machines. So mechanism means it's a combination of links. That is what rigid or resisting bodies means. It is nothing but any links. It is in a combination of resisting bodies which are being interconnected. See, each links will be interconnected to form a relative motion. That is what we called as a mechanism. Now coming to a machine. Machine is a device which receives energy and transforms it into some useful work. Yes, now if you see the difference between the mechanisms and a machine, so different mechanisms are all put together, that what we called as a machine. So what is the function of a machine is machine is a device which receives energy and transmits into some useful work. Some useful work is, what is the useful work mean? Depends upon which type of machine we are going to use. For example, if you take a motor, what is the function of the motor is? It receives the electrical energy and output is, it converts that electrical energy to some useful energy. To pump the water or to pump the any fluids, it can able to function that motor. Like this, so all the machines, the machine is nothing but a device which receives energy and transforms it into some useful work. The machine consists of number of bodies with successfully constrained motions. Even it should be able to transmit the motion to do some useful work. This is what we called as a machine. Now coming to the structure. What do you mean by a structure? So structure is nothing but an assemblage of number of resisting bodies which will be having a no relative motion between them. Only the structure is nothing but it's like in a pillars or a columns where only it is used to resist or withstand the forces which is acting on them. So this is about a machine, mechanism and a structure. So next we'll see about the difference between the machine and a structure. So the machine is nothing but the parts of a machine moves relative to each other. In the structure, it will be no relative motion, only withstanding force. It will be no relative motion, only the force can able to withstand there. In the machine, a machine transforms the available energy into some useful work. In a structure, no energy is transformed into useful work. Only the machine can able to transform the available energy to useful work. Here, no energy will be transformed into useful work. The link of a machine may be transmit both the power and the motion. Example, if you take lathe, shaper, steam engine, like we have so many machines. For example, if you take a structure, the members of a structure only transmit the forces. So there will be no transmission of any motion or any power. Only it can able to transmit the forces. For example, if you take railway bridges, roofs, trusses, pillars which has been used for in the flyovers and even in the columns which has been used in the residential purpose. So wherever you're going to use the columns or in a pillars, only it is, you cannot able to transmit any motion. Only the function is to withstand the forces which is acting on them. So next we'll see about the difference, but these are the some of the difference between the machine and a structure. So next we are going to see about the difference between machine and a mechanism. Now we have been seeing the machine and a structure. Now we are going to see about the machine and a mechanism. So machine is nothing but modifies the mechanical work. Machine means it modifies the mechanical work. Mechanism means it modifies the motion, which is the because of the motion only the mechanism has been generated. Because of the different mechanisms, the machine can able to work. That is the major difference. A machine is a practical development of any mechanism and the mechanism is a part of the machine, right? So without the mechanism, it cannot able to function that. Next is, a machine may be having a number of mechanisms for transmitting the mechanical work or a power. A mechanism is a skeleton outline of the machine to produce the motion between the various links. See, initially how the motions will be generated, a mechanism will be generated because of the combination of different links. It can able to form a one mechanism. The combination of different mechanisms, it can able to form a one complete machine. For example, if you take in a machine, lathe, shaper, steam engine. If you take in a mechanism, only if you consider in a mechanism, we can able to take the clock, typewriter, and even in the PV diagrams of an engine. So these are all the some of the examples of or the difference between the machine and a mechanism, right? And a rigid body means it is only the changes in shape will be applicable. Rigid body means it will be a fixed body. No force or motions can able to transmit. And the kinematic pair is when two elements or links are connected together to form a relative motion with a constraint with a kinematic pair. That is what we called as a kinematic pair. Two elements or links are connected together to form a relative motion. That is what we called as a kinematic pair.